Well, hi everyone. This is Carrie back with How to Homeschool My Child, and it's Mom's Monday Lunch Bunch, and we are going to talk about character. How, you know, a lot of y'all talk about attitudes are one of your hardest things to overcome with your kids. It's one of the things that cause a lot of drama in your home. And so we're going to talk about character and what is the most important character, I think, to get started with. I will tell you that you, for most of you, if you've been around me, I talk about leadership education. I believe that leadership education, the foundation of raising our kids to be leaders and not followers, starts with character. And that's what we want to talk about today. Leaders are ones who grow up out of your homeschool, who will impact others, who will influence others, starting with their own family when they are adults. And so I think it's really important that we raise our kids to be leaders and not followers. And we start that by giving them godly character. Now, if you have teenagers and you're still dealing with the character issue, now I'm not saying you ever get rid of it, but if you are dealing with that character issue even more than academics, go back, come back here, and let's talk about some things that you could do. I do think it's important that when you deal with their character, that you tend their heart, not just their actions or their words. But today we are going to talk about some practical ways that you can reinforce godly attitude. And so I was looking to see what I've written here. Tangible and consistent ways that you could repeat with them over and over and over. And I will just tell you, it starts with gratitude. What is gratitude? I talked a little bit about it last week. I want to talk about it for just a second. And then we're going to go into, I think, three practical ways that you can actually encourage gratitude. These are different than the ones that I shared last week. What is gratitude? It's a feeling of appreciation for someone doing something for you or being there for you. It is an attitude of focusing on the positive, not the negative. And when we show gratitude, it changes the way we think. It is something that's not easy, and I know this is going to be backwards because I'm on my phone and not my computer, but gratitude is a lifestyle. It is a hard fought lifestyle in our life today. It is grace infused and it is a biblical lifestyle. This is Nancy DeMoss Wolgamuth's definition. So it is hard fought. It is not easy to get our kids sometimes to be thankful because we live in a society that's all me, 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 and I expect everything to revolve around me. And so we need to change that negative to the positive. Now, why do we teach gratitude? Well, one, God tells us over and over to be thankful. But listen to this, and these are reasons that you want to teach your kids to be grateful too. Research shows that kids or people that show thankfulness have an increased sense of well-being. They have positive emotions. They increase their optimism. If you have a child who is always negative, get them to be grateful. It'll take their attitude off and it can change it to optimistic. Excuse me. It gives your kids a sense of connectedness. Thank you, whoever's popping the little heart things. I can't see this, and I'm still working on my laptop to get it fixed. So I don't have to do this on the phone anymore, but it's not fixed. Gratitude improves our relationships. And get this, it gives us more sleep and better sleep. If you have a child that's not sleeping well, get them to be more thankful. I think it also helps us cope with stress and major adversities. So it can truly change your kids' attitude, and we start with gratitude. I've already said that God says we need to be doing this. He knows that when we take our attitude off ourselves and onto others and the positive around us, that is what's going to help. Where do we do it? First thing, modeling. Now, I'm going to give you a couple ideas, but on the blog tomorrow, there is an article by homeschool superhero Michelle Osborne. I will link it here because it's all about gratefulness begins with mom. And she gives you some specific ideas about being grateful. Mom, what are you, if you're complaining, grumbling about your friends or about church or about the neighborhood or about the family, what are your kids going to do? They're going to complain. If you are constantly changing and being grateful and having a grateful attitude, then your kids will hear that, and that will be something that is modeled for them. I know that was true with us. We said thank you all day long. A lot of times it was for what the children did, but because we were saying thank you, they grew up saying thank you all the time, and the grandkids are learning how to do that as well. One thing that you can do, I was looking to say, oh, we'll do that in a second. I was looking for my next piece of paper. Where is it? I've already lost it. Well, I had a printable. I was going to show you. The next thing I think that's important is we teach our kids to write thank you notes. And I have a whole little printable. Oh, here it is right here. If you need help teaching your kids how to write thank you notes, you can go on the blog. I'll put the link there. This is just a little template, and it helps your kids write something more than thank you for the Christmas gift or thank you for coming to the house. It lets you give them more ideas of what they could write in a thank you letter. Do your kids write thank you letters? Thank you letters for gifts that you can write them for being kind, for being a good mom. You might have them write that, or being a good dad, grandma or grandpa. I'd start with someone in the family that you know will appreciate that. My parents love getting thank you cards from their grandkids. And most of the time, my kids don't just write thank you. Not, I didn't have this template here, but it is something, if the process is the same, and they wrote more than just thank you for it. They told why and how they were going to use that item. I will put a link there, but you can go online and get this. It's off our blog, and it gives you also some ideas on how you could actually teach thank you notes. So first, we as moms need to model that. I'll put a link to that tomorrow when we get live. Secondly, thank you notes. And then you have heard me talk about this. I talk about it till I'm blue in the face. Keeping a journal, keeping a gratitude journal. That changes your perspective. And when your kids are complaining, and I'm sorry I don't have mine here, pull out that journal and let them read. If it's a family journal, then it's family ideas that we're thankful for. If they have their own, pull their own out. If I had to do it all over again, by the time my kids were probably 8-ish, I would have them writing their own. Every day I'd start homeschool and they needed to write one thing they were thankful for, or they needed to end homeschooling with one thing that they are thankful for, and then pull it out. It also makes you think, look for good things instead of always complaining. I've already talked about a family journal. You can do that at dinner time. And if you need help, and your kids need help, you can take our 30-day challenge right here. And there's 30 days, family member, foods you enjoy, something in nature, a book, a smell. It gives you 30 ideas of things that you can be thankful for. And that is at howtohomeschoolmychild.com/gratitude-challenge-2021. It's our one for this year. All right, so those are just a few ideas. If you want to, the gratitude challenge also comes with a blank one so that your child, you can follow along here, and then you can write it in. If your kids are little, then you can write it in. If your kids are super little, you can also let them draw pictures of something that they are thankful for. For those of you that don't know, we are running our 20 Days of Thanks blog series throughout this entire month. And so that is available at howtohomeschoolmychild.com/blog. We also have some more helps if you are interested in any of them. Those are all of our free ones, but we do have some paid ones. They are each $10. Gratitude activities. You will get a lot of what I've talked about, plus you'll get more ideas. And these are some hands-on activities to encourage your children to be grateful so that that will change their perspective. They won't be so negative. They can be more optimistic than pessimistic. One thing to help moms model it is our Give Thanks, a Mother's Prayer Journal. And this allows you to look up a verse. It's giving you the verse to look up, and then allows you to pray about that verse, to read and write about it, to look for keywords, to ask God how He wants us to use that, and then what you are actually going to do. You could do one a day, or you could do one every 2 or 3 days, maybe one a week. You could also coordinate it and do this Give Thanks to God copy workbook as well. And each, you could do one a week, you could do one a day, however you want to divide it. But every day, every page has the verse, and then you let your kids copy it as well. I think these are great ways to begin discussion. Like I said at the beginning, character is the foundation of leadership education. But as you grow in leadership education, one thing you want to get to is having your kids read, write and then discuss what it is. This would be a real easy way, even for little kids, to be able to read the verse, to write it. If you have older kids, and you could have them copy it, but then you could write what it means, and then y'all could talk about it. And so that's another way that we raise our kids to be leaders. I think it's so important that we raise our kids to be leaders instead of followers. We need to change the world around us, and God can do that through us if we have the tools, a godly character, the ability to think for ourselves, to read, write, and discuss. All right, so that's what I've got today. Again, you can get on our 20 Days of Thanksgiving. Today was actually a Christmas one on handprint ornaments, and you can actually sign up for our $500 cash giveaway. All right, that's all I have for today. Remember, character begins with gratitude, and you model that. You can encourage it through thank you notes. You can encourage it through a journal as well. I'm Carrie Beck with How to Homeschool My Child. Talk to y'all later.